Hi friends, hope you all are doing great and safe at home. Tasin here. Today I'm going to teach you how to prepare a PowerPoint presentation. As we all know, now teachers are taking classes through their online classes or else through video only they are communicating. So let's make an effective online classes. Let's make an effective videos so that students also can actually understand the concept what you're trying to convey. So today I'm going to introduce with the PowerPoint presentations. It is very simple and very easy and user friendly. You can make this PowerPoint using your mobile phone. You need not to worry actually. You can attach your photos, you can attach your videos, you can attach your text, you can explain in a very nice way. Either you can use your A to Z screen recorder, which I explained you in my videos actually. Even I will leave that in description box. After creating the PowerPoint presentation, either you can use A to Z screen recorder to record your actually PowerPoint presentation, or else you can use one more actually screen recorder with your video actually in the top layer or in the bottom layer, wherever you want to fix your video when explaining. Actually you can show your face at the same time, actually you can show your slides. So both the screen recorders, actually A to Z screen recorder and one more actually screen recorder, both the screen recorders links actually I'll try to post in my below description. So kindly make a note of it and actually make an amazing PowerPoint presentation for your students and actually let them learn, live and enjoy.
Hi friends, hope you all are doing great. Today I want to introduce you with an application called WPS Office. If you don't have in your mobile phone, actually kindly install it to make a very effective PowerPoint presentation for your students. So let me show you actually how it looks actually in Play Store. Just let's go to Play Store, and if you type WPS Office, the first one actually WPS Office free online suite, actually just click on it and download. So here I have in my mobile, actually I'm going to open WPS Office. So once you open actually you will get a page like this. So in this page it will ask you actually an email ID. If you want to give, actually you can give your email ID and then enter into this. So you will get a page like this. All your, actually I have my few files actually, so it is showing here. If you have not created any files, it won't show you any files. So let us actually create a one PowerPoint presentation for our students. So here I can show you actually a plus button with a circle actually. So just click on it. It will ask you actually whether you want to make a document, presentation or a spreadsheet or PDF files. So we want to make a presentation, so actually click on the presentation button. So here you can see actually it's a very so many actually styles of presentation it has shown actually. So whichever you want, you like actually, you can click on it, but I want to use the blank one actually because I want to make of my own style. So here it is showing actually double tap to add title. So here you can add title actually with whatever subject you want to teach. Actually you can add title here, and also you can add actually whatever the points related actually to that you want to. Just if you click on it actually, the box actually it will show you the cursor, you can start typing on it. And if you want to have more slides actually, you can just click on the plus button in the lower section actually. It has shown. So here it will ask you actually in which format, actually two column or title only, compare. So how you want actually, you can click on it whichever you feel like. For a comparison you can use compare. So for actually if you want to have a header and actually with the explanation part, you can have in title and content actually. So many options are available for you actually, so that you can apply. But I want to actually click on title slide. Just click on the title slide again actually and tap to add title. So if you want to add title actually, after typing after clicking on it actually, just type it, and whatever you feel like explaining to the students regarding subject, just type it. And then actually now I want to I want to have a colorful actually PowerPoint presentation. So that let us go and click on you have to, before doing any maximizing the size or actually coloring, you have to select the portion which you want to. Just if you click on those letters actually, it will get selected. So once you click on the letter actually, it will this actually I want to. So first let me make this in a right position. So I will drag this actually. See, you can even rotate this. If you are not happy about this actually, the way it has got rotated, just click on the upper portion actually. You can here see on the uppermost layer part actually, the top layer, you can see a back button. Just click on the back button, it will come to the original position. So here it is actually. Now I want this to be in a perfect place. So actually I'm going to drag this on the top layer, and I'm going to drag this actually lower part to the, so that it can fix in a proper position. Now I want to enlarge this part so that I can text actually how much ever I want. So now I have selected this. Actually let me show you how to color it. Actually in the down part, can you see the first option actually with the four small circles? Like actually just click on it. So if you once click on it, actually many options will be available here. You can see size. So once you selected that, actually then only this will be applicable. If you have not selected, it won't applicable. So size, actually whichever size you want, for example 36, 44, 48, whichever size you want, actually you can have for your what is text. And also actually if you want it to be bold or italic, or actually you want it to be underlined, it will be. And then actually whichever color you want, actually you can prefer your color. If you want to have a look on more colors, just press on the three button. Actually here you can see more colors actually you have for your text. And then actually once you're done with this, actually the spacing, like actually how you want 0.9 spacing or actually 1.0, so you can see actually spacing also actually it's getting enlarged. So I will have for a 0.5 actually, so that actually I can have many text, actually I can type many what is it called actually letters here. So let's actually, it is asking for an alignment, actually what type of alignment you want, actually left, right or center. So you can select whichever is comfortable for you, actually whichever. It is asking whether you want a bulletin actually for your text. Actually here you can have your bulletin here, you can like this type of bulletin or 1-2-3. So let me choose for a 1-2-3 actually bulletin. If you don't want actually any bulletin, you can choose actually none also. So here actually next to the home option, actually here you can see. And even actually if you want to have a different fonts, actually you can have a different fonts also at the same time. But as of now I have only Calibri, so actually I will use the same one for my text. And here next to the home you can see the text box here. So text box, actually if you want to fill any color for your text, actually any color for your what is it called, actually background color, if you want actually you can choose any color for your background. So let me choose any light color so that actually it will be brightly be shown. So I'll use this or this one. So whichever you want, actually you can use it. Any color, actually we can use it. Once you are done, actually come back. And then next to the text box, actually here you can see border colors, border style, border weight. So everything, whatever you want, actually like a border for what color you want and which color you want and which style you want, all you can choose actually. Whichever styles, actually you can use it. And next, actually we have file. Here it is all about where to save and export to PDF actually, and export the image, sent to computer, all these options actually are available for you. But as of now we are not done with our PPT actually, so let's move to the next option. It is asking you to play actually current page or a first page or autoplay. Once you are done, actually you can even actually try to play your what is it called actually PPT, and you can see and have a look, and then you click on done button so that it will be get saved. So here actually hide slides. If you want to hide any of your slides, actually if you click on this slide will get hide, and all the others actually will be shown, but this slide will not be shown. So let's not hide the slide actually. Let's go to the next button. Insert is here. So here in the insert, actually it is asking to actually to insert a picture. So let me show you. Let's go to the new what is it called, new page. I'll click on this new page here. Actually new thing is open. So here we will, let's actually introduce what is it called, picture here. So in the picture, if you want to use any picture actually to be introduced here, for example you want to introduce this picture, so just click on the circle actually here shown on the topmost layer. Only one picture I have selected, so click on OK. So here is the picture here. Actually you can insert here and explain the students regarding this, what you want to talk. And then actually here actually next slide I will show you what you can inside. If you want to insert actually any table like this, actually format, even you can slide however actually what the like 2-4 or 4-3 how much ever rows and columns you want, actually you can insert, and you can just resize it, and you can have your own slide. For example, if you want this yellow color slide, actually just click on it and actually click on the OK button. So you have got your own slide. Now you can start writing in the rows and columns so that you can explain the students in an effective way. See here actually you can type your on your slides whatever you want to. Even you can show your mark list of your students, actually many things you can show here. So using this also you can explain. And next slide I'll show you how to, you can even insert what is it called, graph for your students, chart actually. If you want to explain students using the bar charts, actually you have bar charts also here, so use the bar charts also to explain. And one more thing, next what we have here is transition. So transition is all about actually how from one slide to one slide, if you want to move, how you want it to be. For example, fade, it will be appeared like this. If it is none, actually it won't be appeared any of those transition. If you want to be this way, like split way, or actually like this way, if you want to have actually, can you see? So wipe. So this is the how actually like a push way. So this is also very nice. So whichever you want actually apply to all slides. So just click on apply to all slide. Triumph has been used in all slides. Very good. So it is done now. So this is a, and what is next actually we can have. And the very important thing actually what I want to tell you is, see, design clear current background actually. See, we can have all apply to all slides. Just select any one color actually too, so that you can select to all slides. So here I have selected one color and actually applied to all slides. I have given for all slides actually the same color will be actually applied. And the slide size, whatever you want actually you can have. And the layout actually, however, it's again asking you actually for what type of a layout you want. So already we have selected all that. And very important thing here is a pen, something actually which is going to helpful for you, because every teacher actually need a pen. Use finger. So if you click on this button, use finger. See here, let me explain you just a minute. So use finger. So here actually I have choose this pen, actually a yellow color pen. So here I can, you can whatever you want to explain actually, you can explain the students. Once you explain, you just go back actually so that it will get erased. Or else actually if you want to use eraser actually to erase it, it will get erased. So eraser is also available for you here. And also actually ink finger is also actually, it's available for you. It's a very nice option that actually you can use your finger so that you can write whatever you want and explain the students. Yeah, you can explain X plus Y. So if you're done with this, if you don't want it actually, you can just use eraser and just erase it. It will go off. So this is all the features actually. Once you're done with all this actually, just I'll show you and make you a play how it really works. So let's play this current page actually. See, so it is once actually if you move from backward to upward actually, it will start moving. So this is your PPT presentation with image, with charts, with tables, with graphs, with text actually. So many things actually we have shown here. See, once actually if you click on this images actually, whichever image you want to have actually you can have here. And one more thing here, you can see a pointer is available. Using this pointer you can explain the students actually in this chart and everything. Here you can see the arrow marks on the both the sides actually. If you click on the arrow marks actually, you can go to the next slides so that it will be helpful for you to explain. So now I'm going to use the pointer actually to explain the students. Again I'm going to the next slide and using the pointer to explain again. Next, going to the next, if I want to write something and show to the students, I am going to take, just click on the screen, you will get a pen here, and I'm going to use 3 here. I'm going to write 4 here. I'm going to write 5 here. I'm going to write 6. So like this actually you can start explaining students all this. And here actually few more options actually, you want to record actually, you can record this and actually you can send it to your students. So it's all very nice options whatever we have. With all this, you're happy about this slide actually, just click on the done button in the topmost layer so you can see. So just click on done button. It will ask you actually if you're done, then actually it will be automatically saved. And I'll show you. So it is asking when I go back actually, would you like to save the changes you have made? Just click on the save button here. Actually it is asking you which what is the name of the document you want to have PPT presentation. So I'm going to keep actually X here and just click on save. It will get saved in your phone. So where you have to go and have a look, can you see actually recent actually, you can see X actually in my mobile phone. The first one is the X. So like when you want to show students actually, just click on it and just you can see a play button. If you click on the play button, it will start showing you like this. Click on here and you can use pointer, pen, note and record actually, whichever slide you want actually you can take and explain to the students.
So finally, hope you all would have got actually how to use PowerPoint presentation. So now enjoy with your students actually with this PowerPoint presentation. If you have any doubts and clarification, kindly write in the below comment section. Definitely I'll try to clear it out. And one more thing, if you want more of my videos, kindly go to my channel and subscribe. Don't forget to click on the bell icon and like my videos. Thank you so much. Bye-bye.